links that you create with the cells of a pivot table are different than the links you'll normally have when linking to regular cells in Excel. Let's see why. If I link to the data that we have on the right, I'll get a regular cell reference, right? Okay, now I'll do the same thing, linking to one of the cells of the pivot table that we have on the left. As you can see, the reference is significantly different. It is a function. The GetPivotData function. This is how Excel extracts numbers from a pivot table. It uses GetPivotData. Can you think of a possible reason we need a function to link to the data that is contained in a pivot table? Here's a hint. The pivot table we have here will change its dimensions if we modify the parameters that are selected. For example, I can deselect volumes, and the table will reduce its size. Hence, the original reference will change its location. Nevertheless, GetPivotData continues to show the original link we created. A lot of Excel users stop here and think this is pretty much all that GetPivotData does. But that's not necessarily true. Let's look at the function in detail. We created a link to the sales figure of cornflakes in convenience stores that was observed in 2014. The function contains several arguments. The first one is sales, and this is the field we are looking at. We created a link with sales data. Then, the next argument is called pivot table, and it's linked to the cell A3, which is the upper left cell of the table, the first cell of the pivot table. It basically shows we are extracting data from the given pivot table. The next arguments that we will see will tell Excel which piece of data needs to be extracted. Field 1 and Item 1 specify that we linked to 2014. Field 2 and Item 2 indicate that we are interested in obtaining information about convenience stores, while Field 3 and Item 3 narrow the list by pointing to a specific product group, cornflakes. As a result, we obtain the number that satisfies all of these criteria. Perfect. But what if we substitute the hard links within the function with references to an external table? Is the GetPivotData function going to work? Yes, it is. I'll type 2014 in the cell above our function and substitute the hard number we have inside GetPivotData with a reference. As you can see, that's completely fine for Excel, and it still displays a result. This is where things get very interesting. In one of our next lessons, we'll show you how to use pivot tables and GetPivotData to their fullest. This is it for now. Thanks for watching.